Are you able to see my screen, Vivek? Okay. Okay, now see, let us recall what we have studied in the previous class. First of all, we have seen the different types of conveyors, and at the end of the conveying system we have seen the fuel firing system, fuel burning system. Okay, so basically we are having two kind of fuel firing system, two kind of furnace for the combustion of fuel. The first one is called grate furnace and the second one is called a chamber fired furnace. So the grate fire furnace are generally used for the say stationary or movable bed of the fuel, and this chamber fire furnace is generally used for this pulverized fuel, that is fuel is in powder form. Then we have seen the different kind of burning methods. Okay, coal burning methods, we have classified the methods. Then the chain grate stoker, traveling grate stoker, spreader stoker, single retort, multi retort. Okay, and we have concluded the stoker firing with some points. Then we have migrated towards the pulverized fuel firing system. We have seen the concept of pulverizing fuel firing system, why it is necessary nowadays. Okay, that is for the complete and efficient combustion of fuel, and we can efficiently burn the say low grade fuel also. Okay, this is the main advantage of pulverized fuel firing system. Okay, so we are having the primary air, secondary air concepts. Of course, there are some advantages and there are some limitations also of the pulverized fuel firing systems. Then let us start with the pulverized fuel firing system. So how this fuel is effectively introduced to the burning system. Say, if first the fuel from the storage, say here somewhere you are having the storage in your plant. Okay, from the storage it will be brought to this primary crusher, okay, with the help of conveyor systems, then to the magnetic separator. In magnetic separator what will happen, the magnetic particle that are carried by the fuel, by the coal, will be separated. Okay, then there will be some moisture in the coal itself, so there will be a dryer which will helpful to make this coal dry. For the drying purpose, generally we are using that exhaust flue gases from the boiler. Okay, then to the coal bunker, okay, the storage before the furnace. Okay, now from the bunker we are having two kind of fuel firing system broadly. The first system is known as unit system. Okay, this is the unit system, and the second system is known as central system or bean system. Okay, now what will happen in unit system? Say first of all, your fuel will be introduced, okay, in on the magnitude measuring. For the magnitude measuring, amount of fuel is to be sent to the pulverizers. Okay, so this is your scaling instrument. Then there will be your pulverizer mills, okay, that will pulverize your fuel. It will convert your coal into powder form. Okay, then it will be sent to the burner. So the amount of fuel that is scaled over here, okay, the measured over here, will be sent to the pulverizer, that is grinding mill. Okay, then it will be sent to this burner, for the specific burner, and we will have the combustion process. Okay, so you can see for every individual burner there is individual pulverizer, okay, or say grinding mill is there. Okay, so this is known as unit system. Okay, in unit system you will have the individual pulverizer for individual burner. So clear? Now this system is very much famous nowadays. Okay, it has some advantages and it has some limitation also, but the advantages are more important than its limitation. That is why this unit system is more famous nowadays. Now let us talk about the second system, that is central system or say bean system. Once again, there is a scale, okay, to measure the quantity of fuel to be fed inside the furnace. Then there will be a single pulverizer. Okay, you can see here, single pulverizer, single mill. Okay, that will pulverize the fuel. It will convert the particle of coal into the powder form. Okay, the required size. Then it will be sent to the central bean. Next, there is a storage, that is called central bean. The general capacity of this bean is around, depending upon the fuel to be burned, for the 12 to 24 hours. So that is what beside the size of this bean. Then it will be fed to this feeder. Now this feeder will feed the coal to the different burners. Okay, so this is the difference. See, over here you are having the individual pulverizer for individual burner. Here you are having only one, that is central pulverizer. Okay, central pulverizer. And after pulverizing, your coal is being stored at the bean. Then it will be fed to the furnace as and when required. Okay, so in case of that, say the variation of load or say variation in demand, this type of bean system has some advantages because you have large amount of coal is being stored over here. In case of this unit system, you need to supply, you need to maintain the feed rate of the fuel, okay, continuously for the load varying condition also. Okay, now suppose in some cases, okay, the large scale of the power plant, this unit system has more advantage, okay, as for the central system. See, this is the detailed layout of the pulverized unit system. Okay, here this you are having the coal from the bunker, then it will be fed to the feeder. Okay, you are having some air. Okay, from with the help of this air, the coal is being carried out to this pulverizing mill. Okay, here it will get pulverized, it will be converted into powder form. Okay, then it will be sent to this ID form, ID fan. Okay, ID fan will force this air, or say induce this air and coal mixture to this fuel supply line. Okay, and it will be sent to this burner. Once again, we are having the coal from this feeder. Okay, then it will be sent to pulverizing mill. It will be crushed over here and it will be converted into small particles, say in the powder form. Then it will be induced from here, extracted from the here, and sent to this burner. Okay, if it has some solid particle having say some more size, okay, other than allowable size for this burner. Okay, so large particle, comparatively large particle, will be sent back to this separator via the separator to the pulverizing mills. So it will be milled again. Okay, it will be pulverized again. So you can separate the particle and you can send it to the burner. Then we know for the complete combustion we will be in a need of secondary air. That secondary air will be provided by this line. So now our fuel and air in the combustion chamber, or you can say furnace, and we will have the combustion. So this is the unit system. Now this is the central system. Okay, say coal from the bunker, then dryer. Okay, after dryer, this is the central pulverized mill. A central pulverized mill. Okay, from the it, this pulverized coal will be induced, okay, by this induced draft fan, and it will be sent to the cyclone separator. Now this cyclone separator works on the principle of centrifugal force. Okay, the particle having more weight will be thrown in these periphery of the cyclone separator. Okay, and these are nothing but over here, as you can see, having more weight, they can be thrown in the periphery, and this particle can be collected via this line and will be sent back to the pulverizing mill. Okay, fully pulverization, and the particle which are in the powder form, okay, fine particles, okay, these are sent to this conveyor. Okay, these particles will be collected on this conveyor belt, then it will be sent once again to your central beam. Okay, the central pulverized bunker will be stored temporarily for some amount of time. Okay, then we will have, this is the coal feeder. From the forced diaphragm, the air will force this coal inside the burner, okay, to the different boilers. Okay, so your coal is being distributed to the different burners via this pulverized, central pulverized coal feeder. Okay, this is how this central system or bin system works. Now we have seen that in a pulverized coal firing system, we need the coal in powder form. But how we will convert this coal, okay, having some size of particles into the powder form? So for that we are having different kind of pulverizing mills. Okay, these are also known as pulverizers and pulverizing mills. Okay, so there are basically two type of pulverizing mills. The first one is attrition mills. In that category we are having the ball mill and ball and race mills. The second category, that is impact mills. Okay, in that we are having the ball mills and hammer mills. Okay, so this is the attrition mills. It works on the principle of attrition, and these impact mills works on the principle of impact. Okay, see, I have tried to have some small diagram, okay, to get better idea about these pulverizers. See, in this case, the first one, it is the roll and race kind of pulverizing. So this is the race, okay, and this is the rolling amount, rolling, some kind of roller is there. So in between this gap, or in between this surface, if we feed the coal, it will get pulverized. Okay, so this is the race and roll type. The second one is roll and bowl type. Okay, this will make a shape like bowl. Okay, this thing, okay, it is, of course, it is rotating. Say if you complete the diagram, it can be look like this. Okay, and you are having one roll over here, it will get rotated, and again this bowl will be also rotated on its axis. Say this is the axis of the bowl and this is the axis of your roller. So in between there will be a coal particle and it will be get pulverized. They will be get pulverized. The second one is roll and ring type. Okay, here you have the roller rotating on its axis like this, and here you will have the rows, rays. Okay, and if in between, if you feed the coal, it will get pulverized. Okay, and the second one is ring and race type. So yes, this is your race. Okay, and this is your ball. That is nothing but it can be an MS, or say yes, MS balls, spherical cross section. That kind of a ball that we are used. You might be having some idea about the ball bearings looking into this figure. So there will be a spherical ball over here. Okay, it is covered by this race. Okay, and if we feed the coal in between this in this surface, so it will be converted into the pulverized form. Okay, so this is the different kind of mechanism used to convert this coal into the pulverized form, or we can say powder form. So this is the first kind of mill, that is ball and race mill. Okay, to understand the principle, this is the line diagram of it. Okay, from here, say let us look the main components of the ball and race mill first. Okay, this is your feeder. Okay, from where we can feed the roll call. Then these are two springs, if you can see. Okay, with the help of these two spring, okay, we can adjust the pressure between this rays and balls. Okay, and here you can say cage types plates are there. Okay, from which the fine particle of the coal can be left upward and then ultimately discharged to these pipes. Okay, so as and when you will feed the coal, it will get inside this passage. Okay, this will be in rotary motion with the help of this gear mechanism. Okay, so it will rotate, and in between these two surfaces, okay, we will be having the grinding or say pulverizing of the coal. Okay, and with the help of this hot air, the pressurized hot air, the pulverized form of this coal will be lifted in this direction. Okay, will be lifted in this direction. The same kind of working is depicted by this line diagram. Okay, say you are feeding the coal from here, then it will get pulverized. Okay, and then the pulverized coal will be sent to this output with the help of this hot air. Okay, this high velocity air will force this fine particle, okay, to outside this pulverizing mill. Here, now the next one is the ball principle. Okay, say there is a large cylindrical container, okay, in which we need to feed some spherical balls, steel balls, okay, of appropriate size. Okay, and we also feed coal inside this. Okay, we will also feed coal inside this, our roll coal. Okay, so when we rotate this cylindrical arrangement, okay, our coal and this spherical ball will come in contact with each other. Okay, and because of this attrition and impact effect, okay, our coal will be converted into the fine particle, or we can say a powder form. Then we can extract this coal. This is the principle of impact mill. Okay, the large plates, okay, will be in contact with this coal. Because of the impact, okay, the large particle of the coal will be converted into the smaller particle, and in between this smaller particle we may have the attrition effect, and ultimately it will be converted into the powder form. So this is all about pulverizers. Now after pulverizing this form, okay, we will be in a need of the burners, okay, to mix this fuel in appropriate amount. Okay, and it is needed to send into the furnace. Okay, so why we need this burner? We need this burner for the handling of air and fuel for the stabilized combustion. Okay, and we need to ensure the complete combustion inside the furnace. Okay, the flame heat is uniformly distributed to avoid the flame heat is uniformly distributed for developing the to reduce the amount of this superheated spots inside the furnace. Okay, so this flame developed by this burner must be distributed evenly inside the furnace. That is what I mean to say, to avoid the superheated spots inside the boiler furnace. The adequate protection against the overheating of the internal fires and excessive abrasive wear. Okay, so design of burners and the location of burner is to be perfectly selected to avoid the overheating and excessive abrasive wear. Okay, so these are the requirement of burner. Say we are having generally four types of common boilers, burners. The first one is called the long flame burner. Okay, in case of this long flame burner, okay, see how it works. See, this is your burner. From here we will provide the primary air and coal. Okay, so this is the entry passage. Then your fuel will be ignited and you will have a flame like this. Okay, depending upon the secondary air, the quantity and the velocity of the secondary air, there will be a long flame. Okay, at the U shape, if you can observe here, you can have a U shape of long flame. That is why it is known as long flame burner. Okay, there will be some territory air. Okay, to supply to support this combustion process and to support this length of this flame. Okay, so from here you can see, you can collect the ash particle and your molten ash will be sent to this ash bin over here. Okay, for the disposal. So this is the long flame burner. Now the second one is called turbulent burner. Now, as its name implies, in turbulent burner we are having the turbulent type of flame. Okay, say we are feeding the coal over here with the help of primary air. Okay, this coal and air will be sent to this entry of furnace. Then we will have the secondary air. Now in this case, the secondary air is responsible to generate the turbulence inside the furnace. Okay, and because of the turbulence we will have the higher amount of, let me correct this, because of this turbulence only we are having the higher rate of heat transfer. Okay, we will be having the higher rate of heat transfer in this furnace. Okay, without having the longer flame, so within the short flame also we can have high rate of heat transfer. So this is one of the most famous kind of burner that nowadays every power plant uses this kind of burner, turbulent burner. Okay, important one. Now the next one is the cyclone burner. Okay, so in case of this cyclone burner, you can see there are two diagrams, side view and front view. Okay, the primary coal and air are fitted over here. Okay, and we are having a shaft. Okay, this is the axis. Then the air and coal fitted over here will be participating in the combustion process. Your secondary air will be supplied from here. Okay, and this secondary air will, just a minute, let me stop here. Just wait for some time. Okay, so as we can see, the secondary air will be provided from here. Okay, and so it will enter inside this cylindrical storage, cylindrical container, and we will have the burning process. Okay, and these hot flue gases will be sent to this furnace for the heating surface, heat transfer to the heating furnace, and your molten ash will be collected from somewhere over here. So in actual practice, this cylinder is at some angle. Okay, so that the enough amount of slope is available, okay, to flow this molten ash from here. Okay, the last kind of burner, this is known as tangential burner. Okay, in this burner, if you can see, if this is your furnace, okay, this is the containment area of your furnace. Okay, the burners are placed such a way that, okay, the flame of this burner will assemble like the tangent to an imaginary circle. Can you see this? It will, we can assume that this is a tangent of this of our imaginary circle. Over here, the good amount of turbulence is being generated, and we will have the efficient combustion of the fuel. Okay, so these are the burners. So from the next lecture, we will see the coal and ash handling system. Okay, so let me end my meeting over here.